الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بعد الحمد لله. If you notice now, it is open for people to perform the Umrah, يعني after you know the 2 years of Corona, and now يعني also it is okay to drive your car. الحمد لله, this is ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What I like to emphasize, please, yani brothers, sisters who are planning to perform the Umrah, read and learn how to perform the Umrah according to the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not enough that we used to perform Umrah from years. Now I'm, for example, 50 years old. So when I was young, 10 years old, I used to do Umrah. Okay, and I'm doing Umrah as usual. Okay, this is not enough. Please make sure that your Umrah is according to the Sunnah. Okay, from the Ihram, okay, and what are the forbidden things in the Ihram? What should you avoid if you are in the state of Ihram? When you enter Mecca, how to perform the Tawaf, and how to perform the Sa'i, and shaving the head, and or to trim the hair of your head. This is very important. Yani, for example, one of the common mistakes, okay, for those people who don't like to shave the head. It is okay, shaving the head, not compulsory. You have two options. Number one, to shave, you'll get more reward, because the Prophet ﷺ made 3 dua for those who shave. Allahumma arham al-muhalliqeen. Allahumma arham muhalliqeen. Allahumma arham muhalliqeen. Okay, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the mercy for the muhalliqeen, those who shave, 3 times. And for those who trim or to cut the hair, 1 time. So which means both of them are okay. But no doubt, the first level is to shave. طيب, when we come to the issue of to cut from your hair, it is not enough that you cut from one side. You cut here, 1, 2 times. Okay, this is not enough. You should take from the whole head. And if you are using the machine, okay, this is okay. You cut from the whole head, okay. But if you are using the scissor, okay, make sure that you are cutting from the whole head. This is very important. And for the women, the same thing. But you know, because the women, their hair is longer than our hair, so that's why it's called what they mentioned. She should take, yani, one side. Then she cuts like the unmula. Unmula about 1 or 2 centimeters from one side, then the other side, and the third side. Why? Because if she does like that, she's taken from the whole head. So this is a very common mistake. So we should learn before we do the Hajj. And also, yani, when you perform the Tawaf, طيب, the ittiba', there is something called ittiba'. What is the meaning of ittiba'? Okay, to uncover the right shoulder. You uncover the right shoulder by putting the ihram under your shoulder. Okay, this way. And you uncover your shoulder. Tayyib. And this is only for the tawaf. This is only for the tawaf. It is not from the beginning, because some people, you notice them from the airport. From the airport, they are uncovering their right shoulder. Jazakumullah khair, yani, but this is not sunnah. Okay, it is only for the tawaf. For the whole tawaf, because some brothers asking, yani, we do the ramal, the first 3 rounds. What does it mean, ramal? It means to walk quickly. Yani, almost to run, but to walk quickly. Okay, so you walk quickly the first 3 rounds. But uncovering the right shoulder for the whole tawaf, for the seven rounds. This is very important. And also, one of the points, the issue when you go to perform Umrah is not to make it as soon as possible or as fast as you can. Because sometimes, like a challenge, I did the tawaf within 40 minutes. I did the tawaf within 30 minutes. It is not a race. The tawaf, the sa'i, okay, all these places for the dua, dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala and dua. So the point is not to make it quickly, yalla, quickly finish, and we go to the hotel, we take shower, and طيب. The point is, it is ibadah. It is a worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. So take your time. طيب. Follow the sunnah and take your time in the dua. And prepare the dua before you go there. I mean, before you reach there, try to memorize the dua here. Try to think, what should I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Dua for myself, my children, my wife, my parents, my ummah, my country, my job. Okay, dua for my enemies. Tayyib, think. It is good that, because you know some people, they go there. Okay, so they use the media, social media, while doing the tawaf. Tayyib, it is not a place to waste your time in the social media. Tayyib, I will not say it is haram to make photo of the Kaaba. If you remember before these mobiles, okay, they put an announce, it is not allowed to take photo. But now, you know, difficult to stop the mobiles, because in every mobile there is a camera. So don't misuse the mobile. And take a photo while I'm doing the dua, and you're back to the Kaaba. It is not haram, but you know the sunnah that you face the Qibla, one of the etiquettes of dua, you face the Qibla. But you find them, because of the photo, they like the photo to be nice, they're back to the Kaaba. And yalla, take photo for me. This side, the other side. You go there to show people. And also, this advice for sisters, specifically for sisters. Because she wants to make the photo, okay, and she wears the loose abaya. So what happens? When she makes the photo, this is awra. Tayyib, so she is exposing her awra because of the photo. No need to expose your awra, no need to uncover your awra because of a photo. So this is also one of the common mistakes, not only in Mecca, everywhere. Here in Kuwait, everywhere. When the sisters take the photo, she uncovers. But why I'm saying this specifically in Mecca, the men, it is full. Tayyib, you are, maybe she is niqabi, she is covering the face, but she is uncovering this part of awra, because the arm is awra. Okay? So we should take care of our ibadat by learning. Huh? Miqat. And also, the miqat, I think we mentioned this point here, or maybe the other masjid. Okay? We mentioned this point, the other masjid, miqat. Some people think that Aisha is one of the miqat. Aisha is not one of the miqat for us. For us, you are going to Mecca from Kuwait, from India, from Egypt, from America. Masjid Aisha is not a miqat. Masjid Aisha is not miqat. What are the miqat? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam specified the miqat for us. Sail Kabir, that Urq, Yalamlam, Dul Hulayfa. طيب, every people has their own miqat. So, for you, if you are in Kuwait or in India or in any country, outside Mecca, طيب, you should start the ihram from the miqat or the line near the miqat. So, if you are flying from Kuwait to Jeddah airport, because you can go to Medina airport or Taif airport. If you are going to Medina or Taif, okay, you don't do the ihram in the plane. But if your target is Jeddah airport, you have to do it where? In the plane. Tamam? If you go to Medina airport, then you do it there in Masjid in Dhul Hulayfa Miqat. If you go to Taif, you can drive to Sail Kabir. But if you are in Jeddah, then you have to do it in the plane. طيب, what is the point of Masjid Aisha? Sheikh, why you are saying it is not miqat? طيب, please, brothers back, mashallah, your noise. The point of Masjid Aisha, okay, what is the story of Masjid Aisha? When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did Hajj, طيب, he did Qiran. You know, three types of Hajj: Qiran, Tamattu', Ifrad. So he did Qiran, and he told the people to, he recommended them, he urged them to do Tamattu'. What does it mean, Tamattu'? You do separate Umrah and separate Hajj. in one travel. So Aisha liked to do that, but because of her menses, she couldn't. So she was يعني, feeling like, sorry, I couldn't do tamattu. So after they finished Hajj, he told her brother Abdurrahman, radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in, Abdurrahman Abu Bakr, take your sister and do the Hajj, sorry, do the Umrah, but you should go outside the Haram area, the sacred area. You should go outside to do the Ihram. She should not go to the Hulayfa or to Sayl Kabir. No, if you are in Mecca, you have to leave Mecca to the nearest, at least to the nearest halal area, because there is a haram area, because Masjid al-Haram, it is called Masjid al-Haram. This area called al-Haram. What does it mean haram? Like the sacred area. So you have to leave this area. You go to Arafah, you go to al-Hudaybiyah, okay? But because Aisha went there, and there is a masjid there, and it is well organized, and maybe the taxi there, if you notice the taxi outside, they say, Masjid Aisha, Masjid Aisha, Masjid Aisha, صح? They say like that. Why? For those people who like to repeat one Umrah, second Umrah, third Umrah, fourth Umrah. Of course, this is not Sunnah. Not Sunnah. You travel for one Umrah. But to repeat second, third, fourth, fifth, one Umrah for me, my mother, my father, my grandmother, my village, okay, one Umrah for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, for Adam, for everyone, this is not Sunnah. Okay, this is not Sunnah. But if you do it, this is valid, but it is not Sunnah. Because people say, we are coming. It is maybe once a year or once 5 years. So let's do it for one, two, three, four people. طيب? Or for yourself, you repeat for yourself. طيب? It is not Sunnah. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he went there, he did not repeat, but he told his Abdurrahman, take Aisha there. He did not tell the companions, yalla, let's go and do a second Umrah. Because it is good, we have the chance now. It was difficult for him that time. You remember that the Prophet ﷺ were stopped not to enter Mecca in the sixth year. Then he went the seventh year for Umrah. So that's why it is called, now people go to Masjid Aisha. So it is not specifically Miqat. If you leave the Haram area in any place, if it is an open place, you go to Arafah, for example, and you do the Ihram from Arafah, this is valid. Okay? So please, brothers, sisters, if you are flying from Kuwait, you don't go to Masjid Aisha, because if you enter the Haram area without Ihram, then this is a mistake. And many scholars said you have to give the penalty. What is the penalty? The feeding six poor people, or fasting 3 days, or to slaughter a sheep. So the main point, brothers and sisters, that we should learn العلم, knowledge, read, ask, listen to the lectures, attend. If you have knowledge, this knowledge will enlighten your life. جزاكم الله خيرا وصلي الله وسلم على محمد.